Hey everybody. Okay, so I'm going to show you how the validate entry hook actually works. It's used for taking care of error messages. So if there's error messages on your screen, sometimes you want to display them and sometimes you don't. And sometimes you want to do different things like override them and so on and so forth. So let's just go and create a standard everyday form, okay? So we're going to do that. We're going to go into here. We're going to say add new, we'll just create a blank form and we'll say error message demo. Okay, so we're going to create an error message inside of here now. Now, the thing to keep in mind is that there's a couple of ways of actually handling all this, but let's get stuff going with the error messages first of all. So we're just going to put in text box here and we'll just call it name. And then let's say that it's required, okay? And let's put in a, I don't know, let's put in a phone number, okay? So the phone number field we'll put in, it's taking its sweet time, but there we go. So now we've got them both in here. Now for the phone number, we're going to say that the validation message says phone is invalid, okay? So let's just update that form now and let's preview it and see what the actual error messages would be. Okay, so first of all, if we go submit, it says there was a problem and it flags name. Okay, it says the field can't be blank. So we'll go Tom Thayer. Okay, now down in here, we're going to go and put in a bunch of junk. And if we click on submit, it's going to say, please match the requested format. Okay, so now if the phone number, because it's not mandatory, we can actually leave it blank, but we're going to use this message, the field cannot be blank. So let's do that. And if we submit it again, you're going to see that it's going to say the same thing, the field cannot be blank. Okay, so now let's take off and I'm going to show you a couple of different ways that you can implement the filter. Okay, so let's go out of here, out of Formidable Forms, and we're going to, first of all, I'm going to show you how you can implement it using something called Woody ad snippets. Okay, so what it does is it allows you to put in different filters and so on and so forth without having to actually go into your PHP back end. So let's just install it for the time being. Okay, now one of the things about it, about all this stuff, is that there's times where you don't want somebody to actually know what the error message was. Okay? And the reason you don't want them to know what the error message is because it's confident data or something along those lines. Okay? So I'm going to show you how you just basically disable all error messages altogether. So first thing we're going to do, now that we got Woody ad snippets installed, is we're going to add a PHP snippet. And we'll just say suppress error messages. Okay, so inside of here, we're going to say number one, we're going to run it everywhere because this is going to be a filter. Okay, so if you give me one second, I'm going to be right back with some code. All right, one second. Okay, so I'm going to paste in the code and you'll notice that, oop, looks like I pasted it twice. You'll notice that this filter is called FRM validate entry, okay? And you've got a function call of validate my form. So here's the function here. So here's the errors. Now you'll notice that in the values, okay, it's looking for something called form ID. So how you find that, your form ID, is you actually look inside of Formidable. You go to your forms, okay? I'll show you. You'll notice that right here we've got the error message and the ID is here. So that's two. So we would actually go into this piece of code and we would go two, okay? And then we want to go and look at the item meta. So you'll notice that it says change 45 to the ID of your form, and then it says change 125 to the ID of the field. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to change 125 to match the ID of the field in here. Okay, so the ID of the field, if you highlight it, you'll see it's 7. Notice there in the over here, it's 7. Okay, so we're going to change that to 7. And we're going to say if it equals nothing, we're going to return an empty array. You see, errors is an array of errors. So that's what will happen is that it'll return an empty array. So as far as it's concerned, it will have no error messages. So let's just publish that now, okay? Because it's that simple. And if we go and we look at the form now, and we say preview the form in the theme, and I go and I hit submit, what you're going to notice is it let it go through. Okay? So that is how you disable any errors whatsoever, any validation in the form. Now, it's pretty rare that you're going to want to do that when this is mandatory, but there are instances where you want to let it go through anyways, or you may have some sort of field in here. Say there's a checkbox in here and you want it to actually go through no matter what, okay? But it's insisting that you put something in it. So that's how you can disable your messages is simply by using the FRM validate entry filter, and I really hope this helped you. And if you have any questions, please leave it below, okay? Cheers. Bye now.